I'm sure a lot of fans dream that their celebrity crush might meet them and fall in love with them. While it seems like that would be impossible, it's actually happened more than you would think. Some celebrities are totally open to dating a fan, and we are gonna find out who in today's part two list. I'm your host, First One Jaspadar. Thanks for checking us out on Top 10 Beyond the Screen. If you are new here, make sure you subscribe and also leave a like on this video because it really helps us out. And tell me in the comments if you have a celebrity crush. I have for my whole life. Zac Efron has my heart. Beginning our list at number 10 is Justin Bieber. If you don't know his rise to fame, he got famous at a very young age after he was discovered on YouTube by Usher. He moved from a small town home in Stratford, Ontario to Atlanta, Georgia to work alongside him. He and his family actually attended a church out there, and that is where he met a fan named Caitlin Beatles. Even though they were just kids at the time, they started dating, and that was his first real girlfriend, apparently. They dated from 2008 to 2009, but broke up because his touring schedule just got too busy, and let's face it, they were just kids. Rumor has it though that his song Never Let Go was written about her. Don't get excited over the news that he dated a fan. He is now a married man, but he once did say that he would date his fans. During the interview, he once said that he would date a fan and even admitted to sliding into some of their DMs. That would be crazy. And Hailey Bieber came in and just swooped him up. Well, Hailey Baldwin. Moving on to number 9, we have Reese Witherspoon. She fell so madly in love with one of her fans that she is now married to him and has kids with him. Cutest story ever. The two of them began dating in 2010 and got engaged not long after that. They were already married just 1 year later in 2011 and then welcomed their first son the same year. So things moved quickly for them. So how did they meet? Turns out he was the co-lead of creative artist agency Motion Picture Department. So there were times when their company would promote her work. Obviously, he knew who she was and he adored her work, but they actually met for the first time at a house party. Reese says a drunk guy was hitting on her and then started yelling and slurring his words, and Jim walked up and pulled that guy away because it was actually his friend. When asked about their dynamic, her being a celebrity and he not, she says that she loves it and that it actually allowed them to get to know each other better in a more private way. Coming in hot at number 8 is Joe Jonas. I'm sure fans have wondered if any of the Jonas Brothers would date their fans. Well, Joe did, and he was very open about it. He has been open and honest in the past about hooking up with fans and going on dates with some of them. During an interview with Us Weekly, he said, "When we started with my brothers, we would do these videos and we'd get these video girls for the videos. And it was like, oh my God, hot girls for the first time in front of us. I've gone on dates with them before." Let's also not forget when he was with Camila Bell. She was modeling and acting back at that time in September 2008 when they met on the set for the Jonas Brothers Love Bug music video. They ended up dating for a little while afterwards, probably some like classic puppy love stuff. And she even admitted that she, of course, was a fan of them at the time, because who wasn't? I also thought I was gonna marry Nick Jonas, and that went down the drain, so. In spot number 7, we have Anne Hathaway. She is another celebrity who fell so in love with a fan that she went on to marry him and start a family with him. The Princess Diaries actress met her Prince Charming back in 2008, but he wasn't the Hollywood royalty that some would expect her to be with. Adam Schulman was a jewelry designer at the time and was a fan of her work, like most of us. So he was just admiring her from afar until they were once introduced to each other by a mutual friend at the Palm Springs Film Festival. He is the first person to admit that he was gushing over the actress before he even met her, but she was gushing just as hard about him. During an interview, she said that the day she met him, she told her friend, "I'm going to marry that man," and she did. After meeting at the festival, they started dating and later got married in 2012. They welcomed their first baby in March 2016. Their love for each other and their family has continued to grow ever since. Rolling into number 6 is Patrick Dempsey. He and his wife, Gillian Fink, had to be soulmates because their story is almost too good to be true. It's like they were meant to meet that day and fall in love. Back in 1994, Gillian was working as a hairstylist and makeup artist, and she found out that Patrick had scheduled a hair appointment at her salon for a quick trim. She said she was shocked at first and thrilled because she was a fan and he was so cute. Her words, not mine, but I also agree. After 3 years of haircuts, he finally asked her out after finding out that she had become single. And just 3 months after their first date, the couple moved in together. They got married in 1999 and have been married ever since, welcoming 3 beautiful frickin' children into this world. They did have some rough patches along the way though. Jillian filed for divorce in 2015. However, they pushed through and she dismissed the divorce papers in 2016, and they said that they started with a clean slate and they have never been better. Halfway through our list, at number 5 is Conan O'Brien. The late night talk show host loves telling the story of how he and his wife met, gushing over the fact that she was once just one of his fans. He met Liza Powell when she was just one of his audience members back in 2000 at the taping of his show. He says that he saw her in the audience and instantly fell in love with her, so maybe love at first sight does exist. He tells the story saying that she caught his eye because she was so beautiful. During the interview with Piers Morgan, he said, "Somewhere in the vault of NBC, there's footage of me literally falling for my wife on camera." Not long after meeting each other on set that day did they start to date, and then they later got married in 2002. They're still married to this day and have 2 kids together. Making our way into number 4, we have Steve Harvey. He also loves telling the story about how he met his wife Marjorie, and it's honestly one of the cutest things I've ever heard. The two of them have been going strong for over a decade, and he says he knew she was the one from the first moment he laid eyes on her. He tells the story like this. "It was in the comedy club one night. She came in late, sitting on the front row with her girlfriend. I stopped my show as soon as I saw her. The first words I said to Marjorie was, 'I don't know who you are, but I'm going to marry you one day.' And he was right." They actually dated for 1.5 years first, and then they broke up and went on to marry other people. They reconnected 15 years later, and they've been together ever since. That is 2 people who were meant to be. Right person, wrong time, left, came back. Oh, so cute. Taking over the number 3 spot is Jerry Seinfeld. His wife Jessica was just a fan when they locked eyes on each other at a crowded gym back in 1998. It was just a couple of months after the Seinfeld finale aired, and Jerry was one of the most famous television stars in the world. Jerry says it took him some time to get the courage to go up and talk to her, but when he did, he opened the conversation with a joke, which is not surprising. But there was a lot of controversy in the relationship at first when they first started dating, because Jessica had married her first husband just 2 months before she met Jerry. So a lot of people took it as her having an affair, but Jessica said that she had already begun the breakup process before she even met Jerry, calling her first marriage irreparably broken. But even though the timing was not great for the two of them, they fell in love very quickly and got married in December of 1999, and they've been together ever since. We are here at number 2, and we have Nicolas Cage. Who would have thought a night of wine and dining could bring a celebrity to meet his future wife? One of his many fans, Alice Kim, was working at a restaurant in LA back in 2004 when the actor just so happened to eat there the night that she was working. Now, normally they have rules, especially in LA at restaurants, that you cannot ask celebrities for photos and autographs while you were on the clock. But Alice ignored the rules and went up to him and asked for an autograph. It seems to have been a moment of love at first sight because they started hitting it off immediately and began dating not long after meeting. Things moved very quickly and they got married just 2 months after meeting each other. Sadly though, this one does not have a happy ending. They were married for 12 years and had a child together, but in 2016, they got divorced. Rumors spread claiming that Alice actually cheated on him and that she ended the marriage unexpectedly. Okay, this one started cute and then went bad. Coming into our number 1 spot, we have the cutest story ever. I think I've said that 900 times, but we have Matt Damon. In a recent interview where he spoke about his wife, Luciana, he said, "I got lucky. I fell in love with a civilian." And if you don't know their story, that is what happened. Luciana was bartending in Miami back in 2003 when the actor asked her to help him. He was in Miami at the time filming Stuck on You, and a couple of guys who were part of the crew decided to grab a beer one night in the middle of a shoot, and he tagged along with them. But he started getting swarmed by fans, which is no surprise at all. So he asked Luciana for help, and she offered for him to come behind the bar and duck down so he could hide. And that is exactly what he did. That is all it took for them to hit it off and continue talking after that. They started dating not long after and got married just 2 years later in 2005. They lived happily ever after, and they are now a family of 6. I love love stories. I just love love. All right, guys, that is our part 2 list. Before I get out of here though, leave a like on the video. video, and I'm going to do some comment shoutouts. SNT Brown says, I always thought when Emma Watson chopped off her hair after wrapping up Harry Potter was the biggest and best look change. Honestly, I forgot that even happened, but you are so right. I remember being like, it was like when Miley Cyrus cut her hair. MLG Gamer says, yeah, I saw that Grammy performance. A lot of people said Cardi was a little stiff in movement. Maybe it was her outfit. I'm not sure. I honestly did not watch the Grammys this year. Just not the same these days with COVID, you know? X2X says, be natural. I couldn't agree more. I honestly wanted to read this comment out so that we could spread the message because we did a video about plastic surgery and all this, but we need to embrace our natural beauty, babies. We do. I'm getting out of here though. I was your host, Jasmine Hart. I will see you in another one. Bye.